you want to sit here?
You can sit there.
Just sit,
if you wanted
just
to sit closer,
here.
Just sit to take the seat.
James has not done this before. He's no. He's a little out of his body.
Okay,
just sit
okay.
here.
I'll
just sit here.
Okay, I'll sit there.
Okay, thank you guys so much for being here.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Such a delight to have you.
Thank you for having us.
So happy about Hudson Valley Ballers Season 2. In this show, you guys play yourselves.
We do.
You play writers who are, you quit your job at SNL and you open a B&B in Hudson Valley.
We do. We quit our job and we actually had a scene in the first episode that you'll see if you watch it, which you should.
Yes.
Lorne Michaels, actually, we go to tearfully say that we're going to quit, and he fires us before we get a chance. I think it's time, and he just kind of cuts us off while we're tearfully.
You, of course, Lorne would never fire you. You are two of the best writers in the history of SNL, and you've written so many wonderful things. James, I will say this. I think every writer at SNL knows this. You write the greatest wig sketches in the history of SNL.
Yes.
You write the great sketches about gay themes. One of my favorites. Will you please tell me how you came up with the voicemail sketch for Alec Baldwin?
When I first started at SNL, I had to set up my voicemail. And I don't know. I was just a little self-conscious about it. So I pressed the little thing, and it was like, the little thing, it's a button, right?
Yeah. It's a button.
It's a button on it. And I was like, James Anderson. And then it played back, and it was sort of like a little Femi. It was like, James Anderson. So and I was like, James Anderson. You have reached James Anderson. And then it was like, you have reached James Anderson. And I was like, you have reached James Anderson.
All right, I've written this down because I spent so much time at writers' tables with you guys over the years. I just want to run through some of my favorite stories from you, some of my favorite bits. Paula, you have some human tricks that I think it's time for the world to see.
I do.
Show us. Let's start with some fake sneezing.
Okay.
The world's great. Have you ever seen Paula fake sneeze, Paul?
I don't know if I have.
Okay,
no.
Please enjoy.
I hope this translates into something for Tylenol cold or something. Maybe a national. I hope I book a national on this. Okay, I'll set it up just very naturally. Seth, do you guys dust in here?
Yeah, we dust before every show.
Oh, because I'm just. I don't know. I just feel. Sorry.
Wow.
Wow. And even though it's a fake sneeze, I still pee a little bit when I do.
We're very excited about this. We saved a little money today. We got to send our censors home early.
Yes, no censors.
We send our
today.
Censors home early because, Paula, you are capable, you can beep yourself.
I can bleep myself, yes.
So this is important that all the sound you will hear during this is coming from Paul.
Yeah, so why don't I use Paul Rudd for this to yell at him, because I love him so much, so there'd be no reason I would yell at him. But I'll just do it to show you. You know what, Paul?
What?
I don't know. I just feel like this was kind of a special moment for me and my friend to come out here, and then we come out and you're still here. And I just feel like if you would just... That's it.
This is for the kids out there.
These are the things that happen right before I get laid.
Oh, this is. Give me maybe my all-time favorite.
How I draw them in.
We can use it over here. Can you please show me getting abducted from a doorway?
Yes. Now, it's important you watch both. There's a couple actions in this, so don't throw flowers right away. Okay. Hey, Seth. Seth?
Yeah?
I used the bathroom back there.
Uh-huh.
And I looked down, and there were, like, extra feet in my stall.
Uh-huh.
And I keep telling people, and they're not...